I received an email today from Jaylene in Puerto Rico, and she's learning how to sculpt and having problems with cracking. Now, without knowing what kind of clay she's using or how large her sculptures are, I'm going to try to answer some questions. There are a few basic reasons for cracking. And number one, we're going to start off with just the clay body. There are different kinds of clay bodies, and some clays are made for sculpting and some are not. If your clay body feels really cream cheesy and really smooth, it's not made for sculpting. It's kind of like a silk blouse or a pair of jeans. We want a pair of jeans, a little sturdier body this time. So when you're buying your clay, tell your supplier that you want a sculpting clay body or a good school clay, something with a bit of tooth. So I'm going to make a little guy here. And if your supplier doesn't have a clay body that is made for sculpting, you can add a little bit of sand and that can solve a few problems. But I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to make this little clay, this little guy, and I'm going to talk about joining and sculpting. Now, when I join two pieces of clay that are both the same moisture content, I just make a little bit of slip with my wet finger and I wiggle it on there, blend it in, and it's joined. If clay isn't joined properly and it dries, it could break off. If you're having a problem with it not joining properly, you can score or just scratch the clay one way, scratch it the other way, add your water and join them on that way and blend it in so this little guy has a body. So we're going to give this guy a head. So we've talked about clay bodies and it has to be joined properly, either with some slip or some scoring. Also, to stop cracking, it has to have controlled drying. If it dries very quickly, it'll break. The reason why it breaks is clay has a lot of water. When it dries, well, the water goes away. When the water goes away, it gets smaller and it shrinks. If it doesn't shrink at the same rate, it will crack and break. So if I were to give this guy a little staff to hold, this little piece of clay here is a whole lot less clay. This little guy has a whole lot of issues as a sculpture, but we're just talking about size and breakage. So this little piece of clay is a lot less clay than the body. It will dry and shrink first if you don't control the drying. Control the drying means all I'm going to do is just get a plastic bag and cover it so it dries evenly and slowly. Especially in warm climates or a windy climate, if it dries very quickly, it will break every time. So we've got, you can either control the drying or you can make this part of the sculpture depending on what you want to do. But with basic clay made for sculpting, joining your clay properly, having your pieces controlled and not really tiny pieces, little tiny pieces too will break. If we give this guy some funny hair, and you're going to pretend that I glued those on there. Because I quit the gluing demo. So we get this guy here. Those little tiny pieces could break, again, without controlled drying. Anyway, if you get a good clay body and you join it properly and you control the drying, you can have a happy sculpture.